This is the primary Carvin facility.
How you doing?
Over here would be an example of circuit boards that have both surface mount and hand installed components, such as the big capacitors for amplifiers or powered mixers or what have you. And what you see here is our final assembly line. Our assembly line.
And I see V3Ms.
Yes, V3Ms. All right. Being assembled.
So that's a V3M in the making. Can I get
right
a close up of that?
Go for it.
So here is a V3M in the making. Get a nice close-up. How are you?
No, fine.
Hi.
So if you go down the assembly line, you'll see...
This way?
...it'd be further stages of a V3M being assembled.
And these are all the parts that go inside of the V3M?
Not just the V3M. This is a multi-assembly line where our staff here is able to assemble pretty much any product that comes through the factory. And so we change things throughout the day or change things throughout the week, depending on stock needs.
That's great.
So as you get down to the end of the assembly line here, you see that they've actually do
what
all
is
the
X
testing.
Drive? Is that, what is X drive? PA?
PA, it's a PA product, yeah. Speaker management system.
I saw the X, it made me think of Quad X, the old preamp.
Exactly. Yeah. So down here at the end was where we do all of our testing. When a product is completed, it goes to your left there into this semi-enclosed booth where it is sound testing. And we actually do full testing on every product where they're plugged in, and they are checked to make sure there's no rattle, that all the tubes are functioning properly, and that we have a product that is ready to be completed. With a product like the V3M head, where you know there is no wood component as far as a cabinet that's concerned, it's actually completed assembly right here on this line, tested, and then if you look through the other end of the testing booth, you'll see a rack there with all of the user manuals for all of our products, our electronic products. And then the boxing station where it actually gets boxed right there before it ships to you when you order your product.
So if you bought a V3M, it came right down this line right here.
Yeah, right down that assembly line.
Awesome.
Right there.
Can we go through the booth?
You can go through the booth.
Awesome.
And
here we go.
You want to come back and check out something on this side, but that's kind of a cool way to kind of show how, you know, we've got everything right here.
Nice 4x12.
Yeah, they got the cabinets, they got headphones, they got everything they need. Basically put a signal through these products and check them out.
There's all the manuals. How are you?
So we're not having to basically buy every individual product. It's actually done right here automatically.
Yeah, that's good. Thank you for the demo.
This is a testing station that we have here for all of our solid state power amplifiers. Power amplifiers, powered mixers, and so forth. These are load resistors up here. We actually connect everything up, and these will function in place of an actual speaker, so that what we do is we actually connect all of the amplifiers up, and we'll run them for a number of hours to test them. And what we're basically doing is we're testing both American voltage and European voltage. So we're doing 120, 240, and making sure that everything is functioning over and above the specs that we want in order to make sure that everything is going to work universally for both voltages. We no longer have to manufacture with separate transformers for products to be sold in both the United States and in Europe to accommodate the dual voltages. We're actually taking care of that with our new transformers or digital transformers in the product, so that we're actually building one product that services both voltages in either US or Europe.
Awesome.
So as I said, these boxes here are all custom made here at Carvin. And they actually function
as a in place of a speaker, so we're not actually blowing everybody's eardrums out. So we're actually able to fully load these amplifiers up, and you know, push power through out of them as if they were actually pushing music through the speaker. And this is a very effective way of actually testing to make sure that these amps don't fail, that every customer is able to get a functioning amplifier.
Is that also true for the tube amps, or is that also
the tube amps are tested in a different way? These are mainly for the solid state amps, because again, this station actually tests both voltages, and we're not doing the same thing when it comes to a tube amp. We actually have to have a different transformer, because it's an analog transformer, it's not digital.
Sure.
So it doesn't auto switch between the two voltages.
I have to tell you, it's very exciting being here, seeing all the amps. This is very exciting. And I'm happy to be able to share this with folks that tune in.
So we'll now head over to a different department in the manufacturing facility that is all of the cabinet and guitar. And before we get in there, it'll get a little noisy because we've got a lot of equipment running in there. But one thing I want to say is that as we pass through those doors, you'll note that that room is separated from this room for a very good reason. It's completely controlled when it comes to the environment in there. No matter what the temperature is outside, what the humidity is outside, it is always going to be climate controlled in there, because we want to maintain a very specific temperature and humidity for the wood, so that the wood for our cabinets and our instruments don't take on too much moisture, don't dry out too much, and that they actually have a constant level through the entire manufacturing process. So
awesome.
Let's go take a look.